glimpse of a vast blue sea, of seagulls flying overhead, and of the clouds moving where the winds would take them, a distant voice starts to speak.
This is Neverland. It is located a little off south of the coast of nowhere, and past the northern corners of any existing map. Usually, it takes most of your life to find, but I assure you, the remaining parts will be left for the sea monsters to take.
This is my home.
But for the record, it's not just mine. There's a canyon cove to the right that belongs to mermaids. And on the left, a piece of shallow water claimed by some foul pirates. There's a lot more to explore. I've only ever been here since I came. And that's the hard part because I can't tell how long I've been. I can't tell because I never grew up.
This is Peter Pan. A fairy tale from an otherworldly place begins its story on one particular night amongst the urban rooftops of London. Inside their bedroom, Wendy Darling, the eldest, reads from the book that patiently sits in her lap. Her sister Jana Darling listens closely with a small smile.
They say you stop aging once you find Neverland. And my time here has proven that. You don't have to grow old or have white hair. You don't have to change or have the things around you change. You don't have to be stressed about life or worry about what comes next because here in Neverland, it's always paradise.
That's so cool. If only we could go there. Don't you think so?
For a day, yes. For 100 days, maybe. But not so much.
Why not? We could be like Peter Pan. Free of worry, free of charge, and it'll be like a short vacation. You know, to get away from the world.
And that's one of the reasons why we're here right now. A distraction. Because things keep happening. The world's exhausting and they're taking a toll on us. So, what better way to distress than to imagine the unimaginable?
Oh, I suppose you're right. Then, that's it. Can we continue the story, please?
Alright. But first, Jana, could you open the window, please? Just a little. Some fresh air would be nice.
Meanwhile, outside, a shadow silently treads the neighborhood, leaping from chimney to chimney. Suddenly, it stops when it reaches one house with the window open. The shadow was Peter Pan himself, who finds quite the discovery. He tiptoes closer to the open window, listening carefully, a faint bell tinkling in the air.
I have traveled far and wide, both land and sea. Everything's great, but nothing can compare to the mighty monsters I faced.
I know this one.
Let us start with Captain Hook, leader of the pirates, and Peter Pan's worst enemy.
Enemy? No, he's far worse than that. He's a one-handed freak. That evil villain wants nothing more than to get rid of my joy. And what is supposed to be a serene story for me. There's this antagonist who prevents anyone's happiness but himself.
What's going on?
I'm sorry, but who in the world are you?
Good question. Now, you may not believe me, but my answer will shock you.
Okay, but considering you're a stranger who just barged into our house, I'd say we will not believe anything you say right now.
Actually, fair. You know what? What if I just showed you? It'll be easier that way.
Wait, what do you mean, show us?
This.
I'm flying. I can fly. Wendy, Michelle, look.
That you are. It's the work of fairy dust. You should thank Tinkerbell for that. Right, buddy?
Hold on. If what you said about Captain Hook and the fact that you're saying that's Tinkerbell and those clothes, that only means
you're Peter Pan! The Peter Pan!
How?
Many things, but perhaps the question should be, why?
Yeah, why aren't you back home? As much as I want to fly again, you should be fighting Captain Hook. If he's as bad as you say he is, and you have for the lost boys too.
Exactly. There it is. So you see, the lost boys themselves keep asking me for stories to tell, but I'm running low on them. So I went out to find another person.
So you're saying I am that person?
Not a doubt. I was just passing by when I heard you talking about Neverland. Come to think of it, you seem to know a lot more stories just from the shelves alone. So I thought, why not take you guys there? It'll be fun.
Wendy, are you sure? Should we go?
But what about our parents? Our nanny and the dog? Will we leave them behind? She didn't dare say that out loud.
Just this once. For a day and then we'll go back. After all, you did say we could go for a vacation, right?
Haha! The Neverland is the perfect place for you. So, wanna come with me?
In the end, they do come with him, leaving behind the world they lived in.
Come on, everybody! Here we go! Up to Neverland!
Think of a wonderful It was nothing like the story said, written or told. Neverland was far from words.
Oh my God. Truly, I am a genuine loss for words.
It's like a fever dream. Oh, I think I saw the Kobito dust spot earlier. Can we go there? Please, please, please.
Not just yet. You'll have to meet the Lost Boys first. They could be anywhere. Plus, it's only a matter of time till we find them or they find us. So, there's no real need to rush.
But then out of nowhere, they hear a shrieking sound in the air.
Quick! Hide!
What was that? Was that a cannon we just heard? I am sure only one thing for certain can make that sound.
It's them. The pirates. And it looks like they're fighting something. No. Wait, someone.
A ship comes into view with the flag of a skull resting atop the crow's nest. A group of boys stood on the other side of the shore and they were angry and distressed.
So, turns out we don't have to wait much longer to meet them. Say, Wendy, how good are you with a slingshot?
I'm not sure. Wait, what?
The deck was filled with men, and they were loud and angry. There was a boy wrapped in ropes at the center of the mast. He struggled against it.
I don't know what you'll gain from this, but if you get to sleep better at night, know this, you're going down as a monster.
The Lost Boy said to the pirate with the biggest hat and the fanciest wear, behold, Captain Hook.
What kind words? Ah, but I can't say the same for your notorious lot and how you tried to steal the hard-earned treasure that I worked blood and bones to get.
You're all barking no bite! Come on, man up! Perhaps you're too much of a coward to say you had your man do the dirty work and take it from right under our noses.
Mark your words carefully, boy. They better be your last. Men, get ready the planks. Let's give the old croc a nice and tasty meal.
And immediately Peter Pan appears from where he was hiding.
Your silly tricks still bore me. Seems like cutting your hand off wasn't enough to flatten your pride, huh?
Peter, you're here!
Is that you? Peter Pan?
In the flesh. Let the boy go. He means no harm. But I do.
Hello, just a short content warning ahead. There will be knives in the upcoming scene, but please know we do not encourage any behavior that will lead to using them inappropriately. Don't do this at home, kids, and make sure to be careful. Now, back to the video.
You'd be foolish to think I'd go this far for one of your skits, Peter. He's just here because he stole my only way out of this place. You're not getting in my way, even if I have to lose another hand for it.
Is that so? So be it then.
The pirate holds the hilt of his sword and the boy grips the end of his blade. And so, the fight starts.
It's not too late to back out now, Hook.
Never. Won't mind explaining to that dense head of yours, because the likes of you wouldn't understand.
Pushing forward, Captain Hook drives him into a corner, ready to strike. That's when Peter Pan whistles.
That's a signal! Quick! Aim and fire!
Clouds of white powder fog the deck. Several Lost Boys climb on board, knocking Captain Hook's men out cold. Lost Boy frees himself in the chaos and catches Captain Hook with the help of Peter Pan. They tie him to the mast.
Talk about karma.
Fine. You win. I accept defeat. But know this, child. You'll never know what true happiness feels like. I haven't felt it in decades.
Care to explain then? If I must dance, as you say, and you're not doing this to have us pity you, then I've got time to burn. We all do.
You! Over there! How long have you been here?
For as long as I can remember, I grew up here. Not like the others. Sure, Peter's taken most of us from the real world, but I was never from... Wait. Why? What's that got to do with you?
You're the only real one then. I'm just like them, from the other side, wandering the seas in search of a place called Neverland. Because I've read them from the books I had as a child, and I found it. But the longer I stayed here, the more I missed home. Realized I was actually trapped here, not aging. That made me realize another thing. The true happiness I sought from Neverland? Huh, it ain't true at all. It's temporary, because here I am doing the same thing every day, not changing a single bit. While my parents and friends are probably, they probably have decent jobs and wonderful kids, or they're lying in bed of old age and white hair. Discovering you, Peter? You were the kid who could go from back and forth from both worlds. It gave me hope. And so I tried everything, going as far as stealing your stashed fairy dust while you were gone. And look how that turned out.
It was then Wendy and her sister stopped watching quietly from the sidelines.
Seeing as how we've only met, you'd be surprised to know that I get what you mean. And although I wish you could have gone down to a better route, your actions won't be excused.
But hey, if it makes you feel any better, back home isn't doing so well either. There's still war and corruption, and we've got virus going around. is dying down. I think things are going back to normal, so we won't be staying here for much longer.
What? Why go back to your world like that? Isn't it better here, where is it safe and comfortable?
About that, I know that all of us came here to escape reality or just to be free and have fun without the problems of the real world, but that's where all of us are wrong. I learned that to live life, we need obstacles, and to overcome them means growth. Trying to escape from them just signifies our unwillingness to grow up and change. But you know what? Growing up is one of the facts of life. We may dread it, avoid it, delay it, but in the end, we will always need it. And why, you might wonder? Well, growing up entails accomplishments that make us feel proud of ourselves. We feel proud of it because we earned it. Earning means we worked hard for it. And earning for something means growing because we constantly push to be better versions of ourselves. Yeah, we may feel exhausted at times, but it is only that sense of our achievements that has the capability of making us truly happy. So, let me ask you this now. If you get everything in this world the moment you want it, then what's the point of living? Ask yourselves, are you truly happy here?
No matter how comfortable staying still is, it will not benefit you in any way. Growing up and moving on are the only things that have the power to help you find out what truly makes you happy. I learned that the hard way. Being stuck here made me realize that as terrifying and painful as reality can be, it's the only place where you can find happiness. Because reality is the only thing that's real. The future is waiting for you to explore it. Don't waste it staying anchored in the present. Now go on, you silly rascals! Move on and flee from this stagnant world!
Hearing all of that is a lot to take in. Never would I have thought this place would be what it is to the rest of them. Now, people will come and go, never stay for long, and that's now I'm assuming that's what life is to everyone here. But then, still, I don't feel like I should go where it could go. This place is all I know, and I don't want to forget about it if I had to grow up and leave. They'll forget about me too, won't they? Maybe one day. I could leave this place, maybe one day we could change the world. If not for myself, then for them. The lost boys and me. One day, soon, I'll catch up with you all.
Here.
You can leave whenever you want.
And what about you? What will you do?
I'll stay. Someone's got to.
Very well. If that's your choice, I will not stop you.
But do know that we'll welcome you to the other side anytime. You can whenever you want because, after all, for better or for worse,
change is necessary, I know.